pleased to introduce a veteran in the entertainment journalism industry, Francine Brokaw, who is also a very good friend of mine. Welcome, Francine.
Thank you. How fun is this?
I know, it's this great. We love our audience. Thank you. Francine, thank you so much for being here. It is just such a pleasure. You live in LA, but you have a special connection to Laguna Woods, right?
My mother lives down here, my uncle lives here, and we have a lot of good friends down here.
That's wonderful. So very connected with the community.
Very much so.
So you have a new book out. Tell me about your book.
It's not quite so new, but it's still garnering a lot of interest. It's about my profession, entertainment journalism. Mm-hmm. And it has a whole bunch of stories by not only myself, but a lot of my colleagues.
Okay.
And it just actually enlightens readers as to what it is we actually do. We don't just stand on the red carpet and asking, who do you wear? Who are you wearing?
Right, who are you wearing? No. So I have actually read this book from cover to cover.
I hope so.
Many, many times. And it is super fascinating. It's so fascinating. And tell me who was the most interesting person that you interviewed with.
I always think of James Garner.
Okay.
Because he let everything go. He would not hold back. Even when the publicist came in and said, the interview's over, he said, no, I'm not done with my stories. I'm gonna continue talking. He had such a wealth of information. He was in the industry for so long. And we got him talking about The Great Escape.
Okay.
And he had a lot of inside information about that and a lot of not so nice things to say about Steve McQueen.
Oh, okay. For another time.
Yes. And a few of the other people. He was he didn't hold anything back. He would tell you what he thought.
Exactly. Which is so rare.
It really is
rare in our world of publicists and journalists. So now I've noticed as you came in that you have this amazing ring. It spins around. And you told me there's some meaning behind it.
Well, actually, it's from my family, but I usually wear this for interviews because it is an icebreaker.
Yeah, and you can't stop doing it. Like, really, you can't stop.
That's what Kevin Spacey did. I was sitting next to Kevin Spacey in a round table, and he was holding my hand, going like, spinning the whole thing, and while he was doing the interviews. And part of me wanted to say, can I have my hand back so I can take some notes? But I didn't dare because it was so much fun to have.
I would never want to. I would be holding that. So please hold my hand longer.
Yes. Oh, he's adorable. He's fun.
Oh, that's so much fun. Well, what an amazing career that you have had.
Thank you.
Is there anything that stands out to you about ways that maybe things have gotten better or worse for journalists?
It's gotten worse. The
really?
Paparazzi, for one thing. I have had to fight my way through a crowd just to get to an interview with Jennifer Aniston. Mm. It's the internet and the mm-hmm. blogging and the tweets. There's no fact checking at mm. all. I mean, that ruined it for us who are professional, that mm-hmm. we consider professional. Those bloggers, and no offense, because I know you do have some blog. But you can just write anything. You don't have. I come from the print side a long time ago.
You're a pro.
You're
a professional.
We're dinosaurs. Mm-hmm. And we had an editor. I've had editors that look through your stuff, change it, sometimes for the worse. Mm-hmm.
But you have that barrier to entry.
Yeah, you do. And mm-hmm. and you have somebody fact-checking. Even mm-hmm. Recently, I misquoted. No, I didn't misquote somebody, but I did put the wrong name in. And the editor wrote me back and said, are you sure this person said that? I said, oh. Thank you very much.
That's it was good. This person. You need that. We
but
all
you don't
need
have
our own
that
editors.
Bloggers. They mm-hmm. just everything that goes on the internet is supposedly fact.
Mm-hmm. Well, which is very difficult when we're trying to find. You know, we all go to the internet for information, right?
Yes.
And everything we read on the internet, we think is true. At least I do.
I mean, it's there. It's got to be true, right?
Okay. So, speaking of Jennifer Aniston,
yes.
Have you? What was she like to interview?
She was very nice.
Was she?
She was. She was
oh,
nice.
Good. That's good.
I was not pleased with her first husband.
With Brad Pitt?
Yes.
Oh, I know. There's some sad news today.
No. Yeah, well, he didn't seem that nice when... Well, I mean, he was nice, but he wasn't that
you
open.
You don't hold back either, Francine. I like this. This is the
sorry,
juice.
Brad. No, but he... There were some people that you just gravitate mm-hmm. to.
Yeah.
And some people that...
Shirley MacLaine was another one that I remembered you really gravitated
her.
Towards. And what did you love about her? Was it her spirit? Was it her warmth?
She's so open, mm-hmm. and we both have a love affair of Dean Martin in common. So we talked a lot about her relationship mm-hmm. with the Rat Pack.
Oh, okay.
And it was fun. I really enjoyed talking to the old timers about the old Hollywood mm-hmm. days, because that's it's so different than it is today.
It's the real golden Hollywood days.
Very.
Well, thank you so much, Francine, for being with us. For our viewers, this is Beyond the Red Carpet. If you have not read this book, you should read this book. It is fascinating, and it's a great read about the world of journalism then and now as well. So thank you so much, Francine, and we will be right back.